In this video, we'll look at how to customize the DX DataGrid toolbar. You can add new items or customize the existing ones. Let's take a look. I've already created a simple web page that has our DX DataGrid widget. I've also defined a data source and columns, and enabled the column chooser. Our grid will display order information. Let's see how the DX DataGrid looks with the specified data and settings. Here is the default toolbar. Let's customize the toolbar by adding buttons for grouping. I'll handle the On Toolbar Preparing event. This event fires before the toolbar is created and allows you to customize toolbar options. To edit the toolbar item details, I will get an array of toolbar items. You can work with the item collection just as you would a regular JavaScript array. Now, let's add a button to expand and collapse all group rows. I'll add an item to the item collection using the array's unshift method. I'll set the widget type to be rendered as a toolbar item to DX button, and I'll also set the item location to before. Let's take a look at this in the browser. Now you can see two buttons inside a grid toolbar. One button is the default column chooser button, and the other is our custom button. Let's customize the custom option and add actions for it. To change the button options, I'll use Options. I'll define the button's hint and set the button's icon to chevron down, which belongs to the DevExtreme icon set. To add the expand all, collapse all functionality, I'll handle the onClick event and add some custom code here. It expands or collapses all grid rows and also changes the button's icon based on a current operation. Let's take a look at this now. As you can see, the button works when clicked. Now let's add another item with the DX select box type. The DX DataGrid renders the select box widget for the select box toolbar item, so I'll define items, display expression, value expression, and value options in the options configuration object. I'll handle the select box's on value changed event and add the code to change the grouping. Let's take a look at this now. As you can see, the select box and the collapse all button work properly, but their alignment doesn't look very good. I'll add CSS styles to change the element's alignment and the toolbar appearance. And you can see now that that toolbar looks better. And that's it for this video. To learn more about our DevExtreme widgets, make sure to check out the documentation on our website. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.